after a full morning of elimination rounds, we're now down to the last three matches in each category to decide the medals. Two bronze medals, a silver and a gold, up for grabs for each weight categories. So a total of four medals per category. And the first match to get underway will be the women's under 63 contest for the bronze medal, the first of two bronze medal matches between Crachton of the Netherlands and Shin of Korea. That's it, the score's been given. The score has been given to Nadia Crachton. The video jury are really taking some big decisions in this match. They decided she didn't land on her back, and they were right. So 2 minutes into golden score, and he's given a wazari again. Now, will it be second time lucky for Nadia Crachton? This time it is confirmed that Nadia Crachton of the Netherlands wins bronze thanks to a single wazari. Up next, our second contest for the bronze medal, for the second bronze medal in the under 63 category. It's Schmidt and Favorini. Germany against Italy. One score will likely settle this in the time, but the clock is ticking. Schmidt manages to turn Favorini. The great move, and she's got her down, and the hold is on. And that is it. The clock counts to 10. That's the wazari, and the Italian is going nowhere. She taps, submission, and the bronze medal goes to Agata Schmidt. Well, watching as a neutral, I just feel Favorini was making all the running in that match. But in those crucial final few seconds, it was Agata Schmidt that got the throw in, got the hold and the arm lock. And it's a bronze for Germany. So the under 63 kilo final for gold and silver will see Kirari Yamaguchi of Japan up against Agathe Devitry of France. Trying to get their opponent moving. Trying to get them moving, trying to get them onto the balls of their feet, trying to unbalance them so they can get a throw in like an Oso Tagari, and now it's switched. She's got the throw in, and it's an ippon. It's a straight ippon for that Oso Tagari. Kirari Yamaguchi wins the gold with an ippon. So we move on to the men's competition in the under 73 kilo category. Hans Jury Ahibo of France and Urambaya Odgarel of Mongolia. Well, I wonder how long it'll be before the Shidos are handed out. Oh, but the throw went in. And the Mongolian given a wazari by the referee, and now can he turn over the Frenchman? Ahibo just caught in the middle of the throw, and now he's in a hold, and he just needs to hold for 10 seconds to take the match. Urambaya Odgarel has done it. It's a bronze medal for Mongolia. Well done, Urambaya Odgarel, the 25-year-old from Mongolia, takes that bronze medal. He says thank you for the support. Up next, the contest for the second bronze medal in the men's under 73 category. Askar Narkulov of Kazakhstan against Saginaliev of Kyrgyzstan. What a fantastic throw from Narkulov. And he knows it. He enjoyed that. And it really came from nowhere. So Askar Narkulov gets the ippon and takes the bronze for Kazakhstan. So we come to the big final in the under 73 kilo men's category. It's Japan against Azerbaijan. Gold and silver will be decided in the next 4 minutes. Switch from the Uchigari to the Maroti Sienaga, and it's a wazari for the Japanese. The referee waits for confirmation of that. The Japanese coach asking for an ippon. So there's a jury who are checking the video, and this is what they've been looking at. They have other angles as well. Yes, it wasn't full on his back, was it? He was on his side. So good enough for a wazari. Shido for Ishihara. Not applying the grip. So Mamadaliev has it all to do now.
halfway through this gold medal match. And it's Tsuki Ishihara who has the upper hand. And we've already seen how good a throw he can put in when he gets the chance. So a Wazari up for the Japanese. And Rashid Mamadaliev trying to find something to counter it with. Oh, a little dance. Oh, and the throw comes in. The referee's not given anything. Oh, he's only given a Shido to the Azerbaijani for passivity. That has got to be a nippon. The referee agrees. Flat on his back. And Mamadaliev had nothing in response. So the gold medal goes to Tsuki Ishihara, who actually scored both Wazari and Ippon. Terrific performance from the Japanese player. Competing for the first bronze medal in the women's under 70 kilo competition is Joya Viterli of Switzerland up against her opponent Yuzhong Liao of Taipei. Turns over her opponent. Trying to get free. And we're now trying to get a hold on. Swiss coach trying to get his player back into this. Plenty of time still, a minute 45. That's certainly enough time for Viterli, I should say, to get back into this. Just a Wazari down. It's a Wazari apiece now, and the hold is on. She's got to hold her down for 10 seconds, and if she does, this has really turned things around in a way we weren't expecting, and she's done it. Joya Viterli gets a bronze medal for Switzerland here in the judo in the under 70 kilo category. On to the second bronze medal match between Italy and France, this one. Referee. Yeah. Oh, goodness. A straight disqualification for Clémence M for pulling down Irene Pedrotti, not allowing her to compete fairly, it was decided. And Irene Pedrotti takes the bronze. And now we come to the big final in the women's under 70 kilo category. And this we'll see, once again, Japan, and they're taking on Germany. Well, Bock on the defensive right from the start. Well, there was little she could do with that. A terrific throw from Mayu Honda. And confirmation, it is an Ippon in just a few seconds. Mayu Honda takes the gold medal for Japan, their third of the day. Final session of the day. It's the men's under 81 kilo category. Two bronze medal matches coming up. The first one will see athletes from Georgia and Tajikistan in action. And immediately the Georgian goes in for the attack and gets a Wazari. Manages it just inside the fight area. So a terrific start then for Zhao Valashivi. This time it's counteracted by Rizov, who also gets a Wazari. We are all square with a Wazari apiece. We've only had about a minute of play so far. So it's two Shidos to the Georgian, and one now to Rizov. Oh, fantastic throw, and it's a worth a Wazari. And it is a bronze medal for Valashvili of Georgia. And Rizov is distraught. Time now for the second bronze medal match in the under 81 kilo category. It's an all-European affair with France up against Italy. Again, a big effort from the Italian to land on his side rather than his back there. But the referee has given Aregba a Wazari for that throw. So now suddenly the balance of power has changed. Just 10 seconds on the clock. The Frenchman with a Wazari is going to win this unless the Italian can pull something very special out of the bag in the dying seconds. But he can't. The time is over. And it's a victory by Wazari from Arnaud Aregba of France. So we come to the final of the men's under 81 kilo category. It sees athletes from Uzbekistan and Japan in action. Can Japan make it four gold medals out of four today? But the little guy won the last medal match. So can he do it here? He gets the throw in. And now he tries to get a hold on, and the hold is on. Now, how long can he hold down Murtazov? Murtazov doing everything to get those shoulders off the mat. He's got a Wazari already, so that's a score. Can he hold it for another 4 seconds? This is going to be another Japanese victory in the judo. It's a fourth gold medal for Japan. Yoshita Hojo holds down his opponent. A moment's pause as
the judges' table take a moment to just review the video. They decided that the hold did not count. They decided that Murtazov had got himself loose. And now it's a wazari to the man from Uzbekistan, and a complete reversal. A complete reversal of the fate of this match. And again, we stand in the middle of the mat and we wait. And now the referee has said, yes, it's a wazari to Murtazov. So Hojo goes from thinking he's won the gold medal to a wazari down with a minute and a half to go. Wow, and not only a wazari down, but two shidos now to the Japanese as well. No room for any unforced errors or mistakes for Hojo. A minute to go. Can Hojo come back from this? He gets the throw in, and it's been given as a nippon. And he's letting the hold go on. The referee still has his hand up for a nippon. Well, I think let's just wait and see what the judges' table decides when they review the video. I'm not calling this again until it's confirmed. Yeah. So a victory with nippon for Luchito Hojo of Japan. My goodness, what a match that was for the gold medal in the under 81 kilo category.